Hello, welcome to my channel. I am a tutor. My videos are mostly for beginner PC users. In order for the computer to work as fast as its hardware allows, you need to install Windows correctly. Let's take a look at this example. This computer is currently running Windows 10. I will install Windows 11 on it. I need a bootable USB flash drive with a Windows image. I'll start creating it right away. This will take time. To create an installation media, you need to download a utility called the Media Creation Tool from the Microsoft website. I have provided a link in the description of this video. I press number 1. The Microsoft website has opened. In the Create Windows 11 Installation Media section, click Download Now. The Media Creation Tool has downloaded. I will open Downloads. As you can see, the new utility has this name. At the end of W11, I launch. I confirm here. The installer has started. I accept a license. In this window, you can no longer select the bitness. As you know, Windows 11 only has a 64-bit version. If you uncheck the box, you can only change the language. If you want Windows 11 in a language other than English, choose it from the list. I leave English. I leave this option. The media must be 8 GB or more. Now I connect the flash drive. The most ordinary. Attention! Everything on the media will be deleted. If you have the necessary files on the media, save them somewhere. I plugged in a flash drive. Windows assigned the letter D to it. I return to the installer window. I click Next. Here is the same letter. Everything is correct. I click Next again. The process of creating the installation media has begun. Roll up the window and do other things. Many users upgrade their PC from Windows 10 to Windows 11. This method is one of the easiest. But there is a downside here. The update takes place over the old system. As a result, errors, failures, and breaks that have accumulated in the old system can easily be transferred to the updated one. The system is up to date but running slowly. How to make your computer run as fast as possible in the new Windows? The answer is simple. You need to do a clean installation of Windows 11. First, I'll check which version and build of Windows is installed on this computer now. Right-click on the Start button and select System from the menu. Here you can see Windows 10 Pro version 21H1. I must say right away that this video discusses installation on a computer that meets the system requirements of Windows 11. Let's check. There is a link to a special program in the description of the video. When you click on the link, the download of the file starts immediately. I open the Downloads folder. I install the application. I accept the terms of the license. Install. Here I just click Finish. The utility has started. Here I click Check Now. Here I click See All Results. The application has determined that the computer meets the Windows 11 system requirements. Attention! A few words about the fact that a clean installation removes all applications and programs that you installed. On a new system, they will have to be reinstalled. In addition, all personal files from the partition C will be deleted. It is often called the C drive. Files will be deleted from all these folders. If you created folders in the root of the partition C or put files here, all this will also be deleted. Everything will be deleted. If you have something on the C drive that you need, then save them. It is better to save outside the computer. These can be external drives, flash drives, or cloud storage such as Google Drive, Dropbox. How to prepare a computer for a clean installation so that nothing is lost. Some of the questions I discussed in detail in the video. Links can be found in the description. Thank you. installation media has been created. In this video, I made a backup copy of the drivers of this PC. I will copy the folder with the drivers to a flash drive and use them after installation. The bootable flash drive is ready. I can start the installation. I need to boot the computer from this flash drive. To boot from a media, I use the boot menu. On this computer, to call the boot menu, I need to press the F10 key at boot. I turn on the reboot. I press F10 on this PC. The boot menu looks like this. The appearance of your boot menu can be very different. This is a list of boot devices for this PC. I need to find a bootable USB flash drive in the list and choose it. In my case, this is easy to do. Flash drive from the manufacturer SanDisk. There is one item on the list with this name. Use the down arrow key to select it and press Enter. Computer booted from flash drive. In this window, as a rule, no one changes anything. Click Next. Click here to install now. If you have previously activated Windows 10 on this PC with a valid key, then additional activation is not required. Windows 11 supports the Windows 10 key. It is automatically activated the first time you connect to the internet. Here you can click I don't have a product key. In this window, I can select the edition of Windows 11. It is necessary to select the edition that is activated on the PC. If this window does not appear for you and you need to install Windows 10 Pro Edition, watch this video. At the beginning of the video, I show that I have the Pro Edition installed here. Here I also choose Pro. Next, I accept the license. To do a clean install, choose the bottom option, Custom, Install Windows Only. These are all the partitions that are on the disk of this computer, including service, hidden partitions. My disk does not have a separate partition for storing files. Therefore, I do not save anything here. Delete all partitions. I just select them one by one and click Delete. All partitions have been removed. In their place, we see unallocated space. It must be highlighted. To continue, click Next. The installation of Windows 11 has begun. In this window, you can change your region if it was determined incorrectly. I leave by default. I leave the keyboard layout as default. Here you can add an additional layout. You can do this later. Skip. Here you can come up with a name for the computer. I will print this. I am setting up a computer for personal use. I choose this option. Here, the installer immediately prompts you to sign into your Microsoft account. To do this, simply enter your username and password in the next step. If you want to log in as a local user, select Sign In Options. I will do so. Here I choose Offline Account. Microsoft does not want such a user. He's touting the extra benefits of a Microsoft account here. I insist on my own and click Skip for now. Here you need to come up with a Windows username. I will enter this. Many users say today that Windows controls user actions. Follows him. Users who think so usually turn these switches off. I will do so. Next. Installation completed. Let's see the version and edition of Windows. Right-click on the Start button. System. Here, in the Windows specification section, you can see that this is Windows 11 Pro version 21H2. Below you can see the build number. Now you can quickly install the drivers from the backup. I open Device Manager. Devices with uninstalled drivers are marked with icons. To install this driver, I right-click on it, select Update Driver. Here you need to specify the path to the folder where the drivers are located. Browse. The drivers are on my installation media. It's here. I choose a flash drive. Inside the flash drive, I select the folder with the drivers. OK. I click Next. The driver is installed. Now I will do the same with the rest. I recommend that you install the graphic card driver at the beginning. All drivers are installed. I recommend enabling updates, installing them all, and restarting the PC. I successfully installed Windows 11 on this computer. Now I can set up the system, install programs, and use. Thanks for watching my videos. If the videos are helpful, please like them. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next video. Perhaps the video will be useful to your friends. Please share with them. I wish health to all viewers. It was Tutor. See you soon.